Hey, what's going on, guys? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and today we are going to be breaking down 7 transitions in Adobe Premiere Pro. I'm really excited about this video because we are not going to be using any third-party plugins, and all of these transitions can be made with the effects that are built into Premiere Pro. Before we begin, I just want to say thanks to everybody who has liked, commented, and subscribed to the channel. This community is growing full of wonderful, creative people, and those of you who have visited my website and downloaded my packs, thank you guys so much for the support. So the first music video transition we're gonna be breaking down today is masking. Masking is where something goes across the frame and reveals the clip underneath. So you can see right there how in this clip, the fence goes across the screen and then it reveals the clip underneath. Here's another example right here of this artist, Defonix, walking out of a gas station. And obviously you can see that pull comes across the screen and then it reveals him all of a sudden getting into his car. This first clip is on top of this second clip. And then what I did is I just keyframed a mask using the opacity. All we're gonna do is start with this square and we're gonna click on this square on the clip above the bottom clip, the second clip. And we're gonna drag these points to the left here. And we're gonna drag these two on the right, over to the right side. And then we're gonna make a keyframe here on the mask path. At this point, that's going to create a little point here in our timeline that says we want our mask to be that shape at this point in time. So now let's scroll to the right until we get the end of this pull right here, right? So this is the actual clip with no mask. You can see he comes out on the other side of that pull. So we want the next clip to start to reveal itself right here. So let's go to the very last part where this pull is on the frame. So right about there, it finishes crossing the entire frame. We're going to click back on this mask. We're going to zoom out a little bit here from this fit to maybe 50%, and we're gonna shift click on both these points on the right and drag these points over to the very end. You can see it follows the pull. Depending on what slides across your screen, you might have to do some more keyframes here in the middle and tweaking these points around. But for this shot, this pull moves at a steady rate across the screen. So obviously the keyframes worked out quite nicely. We don't have to do very much keyframing for this effect to work. The only other part of this effect is just having your second clip underneath. So if I remove this second clip, you can see now we're just getting that black space. So that's the empty spot for your next clip, right? So we'll just drag that next clip back underneath and there it is. It reveals itself underneath of the clip. The next transition we're going to be looking at today is this freeze frame slide effect. So check this out. It's a cutout of him and it slides from the left to the right into the next clip. So let's just delete the transition for now. And we're gonna go ahead and start right here at the cut, right where the next clip starts. So he's in this kind of like pose right here at the beginning of this next clip. And all we're gonna do is take a screenshot using this export frame button right down here. We're gonna make sure it imports into our project, hit okay. It's gonna be over here in your project panel. I'm just gonna click and drag that screenshot in and I'm gonna cut the excess off of the tail end of that. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 frames is perfect. Now what I'm gonna do is take this pen tool under opacity and we're gonna just trace the outline kind of around his stance using the pen tool. If you want, you can zoom in on whatever it is or whoever it is that you're cutting out using this zoom tool. So we can zoom in a little bit there. We can go way farther in, maybe to like 400%, and we can get right on top of like his outline if we want to. And you can notice when I click and drag, we can get those kind of like more curvy points coming out there. So play around with the pen tool, get familiar with it. So now I'm just gonna hit V on my keyboard to switch back to my pointer and click off the mask. Now we got him cut out and he's above the first clip here on the left. His screenshot just kind of pops in there and then boom, into the next clip. So now what I'm gonna do with this cutout is right click on it and hit nest and I'm gonna hit okay. Now just click and drag a transform effect onto that nested sequence and we're gonna keyframe the position. So we're gonna make a point here on the position, drag it to the right, and then move our position somewhere over to the left so he slides into the frame just like that. I'm gonna adjust these keyframes so that we got the full length of the transition. We can keyframe the shutter angle so it starts really blurry and then kind of comes out of that. So we're gonna make a keyframe there on the beginning and then kind of just come right back into full definition there at the end and drag that keyframe over here on the right. So now when I scroll over, you can see we got that nice motion blur as he comes into the next frame.
camera.
So you can customize the color with a lot of different effects. For this one, let's just use invert. So over here under my effect panel, I just have my invert effect. I'm gonna click and drag that onto this nested sequence. And I'm gonna change it from RGB to green. And now if I just scroll over the transition, you can see we get that nice quick kind of slide cutout effect. So if we delete the invert and the transform on this and we just leave it without the motion, another really popular effect that I've seen people using on stuff like this is turbulent displace. We'll throw one of those on here and then change it to vertical displacement, bring the size down. So he's kind of got like that staticky look, gonna bring the complexity up, and then we can, you know, keyframe the evolution. So it looks like it's like really moving here. If I scroll over, we also get like that kind of like glitchy cutout effect. If I play it back in full motion, you can check out what that looks like. You can get really custom when it comes to these freeze frame cutout transitions, so play around with it, have fun. The third transition is going to be this zoom shake transition right here. It's good for adding kind of like that energy and that movement, especially when like the bass or the kick drum is hitting. So all I did for this one was, you guessed it, the transform effect. So we get like this kind of like hyper zoom effect around the edges, and that's just by using the transform effect and increasing the shutter angle to 180. And then wherever we keyframe the position and scale using this transform effect, it's going to give us that motion around the screen. So you can see the first keyframe starts out as that original clip, and then you know, we got some keyframes that scale it in, move the position around. So let's just do this from scratch really quick. I'm just gonna delete where that effect is. So what I'm gonna do is at the end of this first clip, I'm just gonna cut it a little bit early, maybe like right here on this drum beat. And you don't need that many frames for this, so this is good, about 5-6 frames. Then what I'm gonna do is come over here to my effects, and I'm gonna type in transform. That's gonna bring it up under our distort folder, click and drag that onto it. And we're just gonna make a keyframe at position and scale. And then we're just gonna kind of like randomize where these keyframes are gonna scatter about and how much zoom we're gonna give them. We want the effect to kind of like bounce around a little bit, zoom in and out, right? That's kind of like the basis of like a zoom shake transition. That's what I'm doing here. I'm just adding keyframes where we're kind of zooming in and out on different areas of the screen. But obviously we don't have that blur turned on yet. So what do we gotta do? We gotta turn on that shutter angle up to like 180, and that's gonna give us that blur. And now if we play that back, we get a very similar effect to the example. Next transition is really simple, but you can get really creative with it, and it's just the horizontal blur transition. So here in my timeline, you can see right there in between both those clips, we get that horizontal blur transition. So let's delete this transition for now, and let's drag out this first clip and this second clip. Come to the center of this cut, hold shift, go to the left. That's gonna jump us over 5 frames to the left. Now I'm gonna do the same thing on the right. So we got 10 frames here, 5 on the second clip and 5 on the first clip. I'm just gonna highlight both those clips, right click them, and hit nest, hit okay. Come over here to effects and go ahead and type in Gaussian blur. I'm gonna throw that onto our sequence. I'm gonna change the horizontal and vertical setting to just horizontal, and I'm gonna keyframe the blurriness starting at 0, getting really blurry in the middle of our transition, and then going back to 0 at the end. I'm gonna bring these keyframes in so it's a lot quicker. So really quick, really clean. The next transition is this flash effect with this trippy color overlay. All you're gonna do to recreate this effect is come down here into your project panel, hit new item, make an adjustment layer, and then on that adjustment layer, you're just gonna add a brightness and contrast and keyframe the brightness and contrast with the brightest part of your flash directly above the area where your clips transition. And then when you create your first flash transition, you can just copy it over on your timeline and make a second one right there. So you can see we got two now, boom, boom. And then what I did to kind of get this trippy color effect right here was I just took the original clip, right? So over here we have the original clip with nothing happening, and I'm just gonna copy and paste 3 times until we got 3 copies of it all on separate layers on top of each other. With our top clip selected, we're just gonna increase the size a little bit, increase the scale. We're gonna take the opacity down to 50%. We're gonna change the blend mode to lighten. And then with this second layer right here, we're gonna change the opacity to 80%. We're gonna increase the scale, maybe move it over to the left a little bit. Then we're gonna take the blend mode and change it to screen. Under our effects tab, we're gonna type in an effect called invert, and it's gonna be under channel. We're gonna drag that invert onto our middle layer, and this is what we're gonna get first. So we're gonna change it from RGB to in phase chrominance. Copy this invert effect and paste it onto our top layer as well. Except we're gonna change the invert channel to hue. And if I move that layer around, you can see it a little bit better there in the preview. So you can just stagger these layers kind of on top of each other. So you kind of get like this trippy look right here. And then if you want to, you can keyframe the position of these top two layers so that they kind of move around the timeline. And that makes the effect look like it's got a little bit more movement. And then all there's left to do is just add that flash transition on this last part where it kind of jumps back into the original clip, right? So we have that flash, then into this kind of trippy effect, and then into another flash, which brings us into our kind of raw clip here at the end. This next transition is this smooth slide transition right here that you can see. Now, if we watch it back in full motion, you can check it out for yourself. Boom. Into the next clip. So here towards the beginning of this sequence, we have these two clips without this smooth slide transition. Go to the middle where both those clips meet. We're gonna hold shift and go to the left. That's gonna bounce us to the left 5 frames, make a cut. Hold shift, go to the right twice. So we have 5 of our second clip and 5 of our first clip. Now what I'm gonna do is highlight both those, right click on them and hit nest. Apply an effect called offset. So under our effects tab, you just type in offset and we can keyframe the shift center too right there in the beginning and then just move our point. So it's up to you how much you want it to slide, but you wanna make sure that it starts and finishes basically on the very middle frame. You don't wanna have it ending on a frame that's not, you know, aligned with the next clip. So you wanna make sure that your second point is like pretty much perfectly aligned on the sides so that it looks right with the second clip. So I'm gonna drag that second keyframe down here to the end. I'm gonna right click on this first keyframe, temporal interpolation, ease out. Second keyframe, right click on it, ease in. And then I can drop down this shift center too. And then I can adjust the speed ramping for this smooth slide effect. So I can just drag that handle out a little bit. And then what I'm gonna do is just add a little of my own blur onto this. So I'm just gonna type in blur. Let's just choose that Gaussian blur, change it from horizontal and vertical to just horizontal since we're going from left to right. And then we're gonna keyframe the blurriness starting at 0. And then in the middle of this transition, it'll get really blurry. And then at the end, it'll come right back out of that back to normal. So as you can see there, it gets really blurry and then back to normal towards the end. Now when I play this back, and this one's really customizable too. With this second one, I added an overlay on top of it. So that's what this kind of red texture is. You can get these texture overlays in my texture overlay pack on venturevisuals.com. I've also got a bunch of other texture overlays that you can use on your videos and in your transitions to make them look more custom. So if you're interested in that, definitely check out the link down below. And now onto our final music video transition for today, which is just these saber transitions right here. So there are these glowing line transitions you can get by downloading either my free pack on venturevisuals.com or the full saber transition pack, which is 25 of these glowing line transitions. And you don't need any third-party plugins to make these transitions happen. You just need to download the files in my saber pack. So if I wanna change the color to these lines, for example, we can just type in HLS, come to color balance, HLS, drag one of those onto our line and make a keyframe for hue, change the color of our line if we want it to change throughout our transition, right? So it starts green and gets blue. So these transitions are really customizable and I think they work really great for music videos. All of these transitions are going to look different depending on your footage and how you use them creatively. So have fun, be creative, and click around inside the program and experiment with the different effects within Premiere Pro. If you're a creative person who loves watching tutorials and enhancing their visuals, definitely consider hitting the subscribe button down below. Gonna be dropping a lot of new tutorials on this channel as well as a lot more visual assets on my online store, venturevisuals.com. And I'd love for you guys to stay on the journey with me. This is gonna be a great year and I'm excited to see what we all create. Thanks so much for tuning into this video. Until next time, I'm Jake Fenner. Peace out.